A little after 4 o'clock this morning, Trooper Everett Riblin was called out to a deadly scene on U.S. 52 in Davidson County.
Ran off the left side of the road, struck a guardrail, went back on the roadway, crossing 64.
A CRV swerved off the road, flipping over. Two other cars hit it.
There was no front illumination on the vehicle, and it was sideways to the traffic once it came to rest. And both drivers stated they didn't see it before impact.
Trooper Riblin says 21-year-old Anario Rosales was driving. His uncle, Salomon Acuna, was in the passenger seat. Rosales was buckled up. His uncle was not.
We're particularly looking for seat belts just for this reason, because hopefully that could have potentially saved him.
Family tells me when they got the call this morning, they thought it was Salomon picking his nephew up for work. Instead, they learned he died, and now they're spending this 4th of July making funeral arrangements.
You don't know when a crash is going to happen. It just happens, and you have to be prepared for it.
This week, there are more people on the roads, and troopers say that means more risks. That's why they're cracking down with Operation Firecracker. Last year during the 4th, there were more than 200 crashes across the area. Around 100 people were arrested for DUI.
You know that you saved the life of the impaired driver, and you know you saved countless others as well whenever that happens.
Lives these troopers are trying to save, especially during a time when they see too many deadly crashes.
We're celebrating an exciting time for our country. Our country's liberty. We don't want to have to go to someone's family and let them know that they're not coming home.